Church of Reason, Shalom.
Shalom.
And welcome to Culture Buzz.
Thank you.
And happy birthday.
Thank you.
You are 20 years old, according to our calculation.
We are all 20 years old, especially.
Or maybe we should ones. Maybe we should say 20 years young.
As a band.
And you have been very central in Israeli music for the last 20 years. You came from Sderot. And you have conquered the mainstream and center of Israeli music. How did you do it?
We came with the power of the Qassams.
The rockets.
Nobody know how we did it. We don't know how we did it. We just did it for 20 years. And now we're enjoying it.
If I'm not wrong, you are one of the few bands that managed to stay together for such a long time, thanks to fantastic albums, wonderful hits. My favorite is Yadayim Lemala, but I am biased. Can you tell us a bit about your music?
I would answer this question if you don't mind, and I must say that I'm not a part of the band. I've been a part of the band only for the last few months. I represent the Mediterranean Andalusian Orchestra,
okay,
which this concert is held together with.
Okay.
When I came to work on that project, on this project with the Mind Church, with the Church of Reason, I was a bit intimidated from the possibility that the collaboration will not work together. We are an orchestra that plays classical Eastern music, and they are a hardcore rock band. And one of the amazing things that I discovered about the music, as much as I went deeper and deeper, is that the music has very strong Mediterranean roots. It is rock in the full sense of the word, but it has very strong Mediterranean roots in the melodies, in the harmonies, etc.
Basically, we are talking about Oriental rock.
Oriental rock, but not one that is trying to be world music or to be nice in any way, but hardcore Oriental rock, just rock that comes from this region, from exactly this country.
Right. We have asked about your music. You have a fantastic soloist. I mean, every time you open the radio, you can recognize the voice before you recognize the band. Maybe a few words from your wonderful soloist.
It's difficult to talk about me and my voice. I'm trying to do my best. That's all I can say.
Can I talk about him?
Yes. Please.
Well, he studied everything you know about singing in the synagogue.
Uh-huh.
This is how his last name is Chazan, and Chazan in Hebrew is the one that sings in
Cantor.
The synagogue.
Cantor.
Cantor?
Yeah.
So I think that's also defined our Mediterranean roots, or because you can hear it when he sings. Even if he sings rock songs, he still got this thing that he's got from the childhood, from his father.
It's power.
Thank you.
How much from Sderot, where you grew up, we can find in your music?
I think everything, because our childhood is the root. And I think everything that you're doing as a grown man or as an artist come from your childhood.
Maybe it's a signature that we come from with us, and it's a bit growing up with us together. So I think this is the...
Sorry to interrupt.
And for some reason, some fantastic musicians come from Sderot. Kobi Oz is another example. And you have cooperated with Kobi, I think.
Kobi was the producer of one of the records.
One of the albums?
Yeah.
The yellow one.
The one that I had at home as a child.
Yeah, we start working on this album in Sderot, in Kobi's room. and then we stopped. And like 3 albums after our first album, we go back and cooperate and did the album with Colin. That's we started in Stone Rock. This was one of our most successful albums.
I know that normally musicians are not so happy to discuss it, but I would like to ask you anyways. How do you write your music? Is it a democratic process, or there are one or two, like Lennon, McCartney, you know?
It's not democratic.
It's not, it's a fascism of the majority. This is how I see it, because if there's a song, and there's one who don't like the song, we can't do anything with it. But if everybody like it, then we can work on it. So it's not democratic, because it has to be a decision
unanimous
that everybody takes.
Yeah.
You have performed all over Israel. You have produced numerous albums. What is next for Knesiyat HaSechel, the Church of Wisdom?
Tom Williams. as the person who who just joined this wonderful ensemble lately, I can say that we just started to make an album. We got together to make an album, and the work together was so right and so organic for the orchestra and the band that automatically we took the fact that they needed to do their 20 years tour and put our collaboration on it and rearranged all their big hits to the orchestra, to this collaboration of the orchestra and the band. And given the success of this, we just released a song to the radio. I can say, because I never had a hit on the radio, that the reactions are amazing, far more than anything else that the orchestra have ever done and was heard of, that we are automatically starting to think about doing projects abroad. Yoram sings both in Moroccan, Arabic, and in French. Ran writes in all kind of languages. I think he writes in languages that he doesn't speak even.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I think that the next goal after we're finishing our big tour, because we are really doing the biggest halls in Israel currently with this tour, is to go out and to conquer the world in
this,
a good way.
This is in a peaceful way.
Yes.
This is fantastic news.
For us as well.
And the sentence in English will be probably, it's about time. or what took you so long?
Only 20 years.
But as we said before, you are only 20 years young. Knesiyat HaSechel, representative of the Andalusian orchestra, after talking to you, Church of Wisdom, we feel a little bit wiser.
Thank you.
Toda rabba, mazal tov. Shalom, shalom.